Good afternoon, friends, and welcome to the finals hall here in Munich, Germany, for an action-packed day of finals, starting off with 50-meter rifle, three positions women. I'm Hilary Russell, and have the pleasure of having Germany's one-time World Cup gold medalist in this discipline. Henry Hungenell here with me today. Welcome, Henry, and thanks for joining us.
It's a pleasure to be here.
It's nice to have you here. I always love doing interviews with you. Unfortunately, that's not going to happen today. But, you know, you do more than just the 3P event.
Yeah, the Bundesliga season in Germany just started. And that's rather the focus than 3P right now. It's a little sad that the ISSF World Cup Final is so late this year.
Yeah, it is. It is really late. And we can feel that in the air with the chill in the air here in Munich. It's always cold, but these days are really, really chilly. You know, we've got basically the elite, the best of the best that have been invited here to Germany to duel it out for this World Cup final. Would you say that it's the most important event of the year?
Depends. Some shooters definitely take it as the most important competition of the year, but it's also just a nice atmosphere. It's a nice competition where the best actually can talk with each other. They have the opportunity to spend some time together because it's not such a busy schedule as most other World Cups. And I really like the atmosphere as a competition itself. It's a little out of the season, I guess.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I think that you're right there. But it is right. You were saying it's really intimate. It's nice also because all of the athletes and generally everyone who's working this program here are all staying at the same hotel as well.
Yeah.
And so you really do have a chance to catch up during the day, during the competitions, and then again at nighttime, which is it's really, really nice. I like it. And then, of course, at the end of our time here, tomorrow afternoon, they have the Champions Trophy, which is a fun event.
I've actually never took part in it.
No.
I hope that my phone will be good enough to get a start this year.
It is fun because the in the finals hall, it just gets really, really rowdy, and the noise level goes up 100%, and music is played, and people are screaming. And then in the end, whoever wins goes home with a nice beefy check, which is great.
Yeah.
So in a couple of minutes, almost about 30 seconds or so, we're going to have a chance to meet these fine athletes. And we've got some serious, serious talent here today. And, you know, this whole new finals format is a totally different final. You know, generally before it was qualifications, you would do all three positions, then the final itself would be in standing. And now we're going to be able to see all three positions. How difficult is that changeover?
It is very tricky. You have to be confident in each position to actually get into your rhythm very fast. And if you struggle in the beginning, you shoot the first couple of shots badly, you're basically screwed.
Yeah.
And you need a really, really solid position where you make up 2 or 3 points to actually get a chance again to shoot into the medals.
That's right. That's right. And here they are, our 8 finalists today. We'll have a chance just to go over who's who, and then we'll go over some of what you can expect to see in the next almost 45 minutes. It ends up being a really long final with the changeover times, because we've got a 7-minute changeover and also a 9-minute changeover. So it does take some time to get through these.
Here in Munich 2013, and the International Shooting Sport Federation, we welcome you to the Olympic shooting range here in Munich. The finals competition for the 50-meter rifle three-position women's event will now take place.
And here we go in position H, representing the United States of America. We have Jamie Byerly Gray.
She didn't shoot all season long, so it will be interesting how she does in the final. It will be her first final, I guess, with that format.
Yes, in fact. Had some problems with her back, but let's see how it goes for her. It will be really interesting. In position G, representing France, we have Laurence Brise.
She did very well at the European Championships in Osijek, so it will be that was the closest competition, so she could be in good shape for today.
Great. In position F, representing Norway, we have Malin Westerheim.
She's a very talented shooter, and it's her birthday today, so I hope she will make herself a little gift and go home with the trophy.
And you can hear the crowds are very, very pleased to see her in today's final. It is her birthday, and what a way to spend your birthday, definitely. On firing point E, representing India, we have Latia Goswami.
I actually don't know a lot about her, but she was in several World Cup finals, so it will be interesting.
In position D, representing the People's Republic of China, we have Wu Liuxi.
She's definitely one of the best shooters. She participated in the Olympics 2008 and 2004, so she's a good shooter, no doubt.
In position C, representing Italy, we have Petra Zublasing.
She just settled down back in Italy after being in the United States for 3 years. So she has some change in her life, but it will be interesting.
On position B, representing Serbia, we have Andrea Arsovic.
I actually can't say a lot about her either, but she won gold in Fort Benning and Shenwang this year, so...
I think she's up and coming.
Yeah,
she really is. Someone to keep our eye on.
Yeah.
And in position A, representing the Czech Republic, we have Adela Sikorova.
Yeah, the bronze medalist from the Olympics Games. She also went into the finals first, so she's having a very solid past 1.5 years.
Okay, great. So let's just go over what we're going to expect to see. After qualifications, all of these women are starting off with zero. Their qualification scores do not come over into the final. And there is some controversy about that, but I think that people are beginning to get used to it a little bit. Some people are still having a little bit of a difficulty with it. But after that, they're going to be starting off in the kneeling position, and the women have 200 seconds to shoot at three series of five shots. I'm sorry, 200 seconds for each series. Then we're going to go over and have a 7-minute break for the changeover and sighting time. They move over then onto the prone position, and once again they shoot at three series of five shots, but this time they have 150 seconds per series. Now, what do you think about 200 seconds for this in the kneeling position? Is that enough?
It's enough if you have a solid position. how I said earlier, if you struggle, you really have to fight, not to get into time trouble, and you can't fix anything. So it's tough.
Now, if you're weak in the kneeling position and stronger in the prone or in the standing positions, can you get back what you've lost?
If you don't totally screw it up, if you shoot eights everywhere, you're out of the game. Mm-hmm. But you definitely have a chance if you shoot a solid... like a 104.5 prone and with the 10 string, like the old form, and a solid standing, you can definitely make up a lot. Especially most of the really good sling shooters struggle a little bit in standing, so it evens out.
Okay,
so
all right.
Sometimes.
And here she is, Petra Zublasing. She spent quite a few years there in America studying. Also, her boyfriend, Nico Campriani. Also yourself.
Yeah.
You know, there's a lot of you guys that have hit America or England to do some studying, and your English is just fantastic, I have to say.
Thank you. Shooting in the United States is definitely a great opportunity to combine shooting and studying if you want to go to college. Mm-hmm. And, yeah, it's just a nice opportunity.
Great. That's great. Now we've got Wu Liuxi. How hard is it to calm your heartbeat down? I mean, how do you do this if your heartbeat is racing so fast?
You can regulate it a little bit with your breathing, mm-hmm. but just a little bit. you just have to learn to shoot under tension, under pressure.
Right.
It's an experience thing. The more competitions, mm-hmm. the more competitions you shoot, the more experience you get with it, and the easier you can get along with it.
Would you say that you then definitely have to have a way of, I mean, your training must be in many different parts. Yeah. You must have mental training, you must have physical training, and then as far as training, as far as your breathing goes and your heart rate, is that a different, would you say that's another?
I mean, shooting itself is mental training a little bit.
Okay.
But, yeah, I definitely do sports. The more athletic you are, the lower your heart rate is. So I try to compensate that a little bit through sports.
Okay, let's just take a look at the standings. We have Arsovic, who's holding on to first place by 0.5 point. Sikorova in second place. She's only 0.3 of an advantage over Breeze, who's tied up now with Vesterhem. Zublasing is holding on to fifth place, only 0.1 of a point behind. It's really, really tight right now, and we've only gone through the first series. We still have two more series to go in the kneeling position. What do you think?
I mean, 52.0 is fabulous. That's awesome in kneeling. But even Jamie with a 49.9, nothing is lost.
Right.
I mean, if she gets back into the 10 wing, can shot more solid 10s, and she will be just fine.
Nice. Starting off with a 10.6 for Arsovic. As we were saying before, this is a woman that we really have to keep our eye on. She's coming out of nowhere this year, more or less, and really has done a great job putting her name out there. And, of course, Sikorova, she's also a very young woman. Breeze starting off with a 9.8. Now, what would you say, Henry, is basically the range you want to be in the kneeling position as far as your shots go? What number? Of course, a 10.9 is where you want to be, what would you say is acceptable?
Acceptable. It depends. If you're a strong standing shooter, you're probably happy if you shoot 51 average, something like that. If you are a pretty good kneeling shooter, you can shoot similarly to prone. You can shoot 52, 53.
Okay.
I mean, some people can. I can't.
What would you say is your strongest position?
I'm prone,
yeah, obviously. You are a prone shooter.
But everything is possible with the new format. That's true. Have the other case, like Marlin, with 10.0, 10.0, 10.1, you can't be happy with it.
Right. Nice. A 10.7 there for Zublasing. And you can see here on our screen the deep breathing that she was doing, and then she just kind of calms right back down.
And you can also see a little movement at the nozzle. She's having a little pulse. So
nice. Jamie finishing off. It's a really good series she just had. Two 10.7s, a couple 10.5s. Very nice work.
Yeah, and I was saying, after the 49.9, you just have to get a good string, and you're back in the game.
And she's one, you know, that always comes up from behind, and like on the last two shots, will nail the gold.
That's good enough.
Exactly. We have about 45 more seconds left in the series. I have to say they're pretty quick, these guys. And you're right, you know, with Jamie Gray shooting at 52.6, that jumped her right up the scoreboard. She was in eighth place. She is now holding on to third place. We have Sikorova still up. Actually, she has overtaken Arsovic by 0.5 point. We've got Gray 0.2 of a point behind. Vesterhelm is 0.1 of a point behind. And Zublasing 0.7 of a point. I mean, these are just 0.1 of a point separating each one of these women. But I find it really interesting, once you do the switch over to the next position, you think, okay, somebody is holding on to first place, they're doing a great job, then all of a sudden all hell breaks loose, and you say, wait a minute, what just happened here? This person's now in eighth place.
I mean, especially in standing, it can always happen that somebody shoots an eight. I've even seen sevens this season. So if you got a 3-point lead over prone and kneeling, you can lose everything with one shot.
Right. That's what you just don't want to have happen. Goswami. She is currently in eighth place. Nice. Starting off with a 10.7. And we're starting off with a 9.5. I'll tell you, the People's Republic of China have just had a banner week so far. We have had four finals up until today, and they have been on the highest step of the podium three times. And so we're all getting used to the Chinese anthem, and I think we could all sing it by now.
I think it's an advantage for them that they don't participate in the Bundesliga, because I would say half of the shooters here at least shoot focus on air rifle over the winter term. And Nico and Petra actually just came back from China, and they have over 20 people still shooting small war and at their Olympic range in Beijing. Mm-hmm. So, yeah, they don't care if it's winter or summer.
That's right.
They have enough shooters that shoot six times a week, 6 hours a day.
Right, they do. They've got an amazing team. Now, tell me, where were you in the United States shooting?
In Kentucky.
In Kentucky. So going from Kentucky, where it's really quite warm, and then coming back here, is it okay, or do you feel like Kentucky's pretty cool?
Actually, it's just really hot over the summer time. But I've always went back home over the summer, summer break. So I missed out the really hot season of the year. And over the winter, it's fairly similar.
Okay.
Maybe not as rainy as in Germany, but it's fairly similar.
Okay. We've got Vestavelm finishing off with a 10.2.
Yeah, that's okay.
That is okay. And I think we're going to have a tie here for first place at the moment.
Yeah, Arsovic and Cray.
Now tell me just quickly, or to brief the viewers right after this, what's going to be happening?
The shooters will be focused on how can I set up my gun as fast as possible. So you can't lose any time thinking about your kneeling. It's just you don't have that time.
Okay.
You just have to switch and go into the future and think about
as fast as you can. You can see they're going to start moving really fast to get things changed around here. We've got a tie now for first place between Arsovic and Gray. Gray has moved up that scoreboard so fast. They are holding on to the lead by 7/10 of a point over Westerhelm, who has moved up the scoreboard. Zublasing is in fourth place. She's a 0.5 of a point behind Westerhelm. And Breeze is only 0.1 of a point behind. It's still very, very close. We're going to be going into the prom position now, and they're going to have a 7 minutes changeover and preparation time, and we'll check back in after that happens. All right, Henry.
Okay.
And I'm back here again with Germany's Henry Jungenell. We're moving over into the prom position for the three position competition here, or final here, and things changed around quite drastically on the scoreboard. We had Sikorova that was holding on to first place during a couple of the series. Now she's down into eighth place. What do you suppose that we're going to be seeing here now, Henry?
I would actually assume that Pone doesn't change the scoreboard too much. It will still stay fairly close within 3 or 4 points. Usually everybody shoots 10.2, 10.3 average in Pone, something around that. As long as you're not a Pone specialist or something. And so I think it will stay pretty consistent.
Okay, all right. What position would you say is the hardest to change from, to going from, would it be kneeling to prone or prone to standing?
That's a tough question.
I guess it would be individual also.
Yeah,
but
very
is there,
individual.
You know, does your body get more tired in one position going to another one?
Coming back to the first question, the problem is in between kneeling and prone, you have 2 minutes less. So the time frame itself is very, very short. I remember in Chiang Mai when I won the final, I just had 3 siders in prone. And my first shot was a 7, and the second and third were 8. Mm-hmm. So I was basically lost. So if you struggle to change over very fast, then you're just missing out on preparation shots, side shots.
Which is, and you do, you have to move really, really fast. And there's a lot of things that you've got to change, you know, not only your position, but you have to change over, you know, your equipment as well. You've got to change things around there. That I think, whoa, a 10.9 for Wu, that's basically how you do it, climbing up the scoreboard. Okay, and we have got Goswami here. She's starting off this series really quite sturdy. But would you say that prone is basically the most stable?
I would think so, yes.
Yeah.
And also here, we are shooting indoors, so you don't have to watch the wind or anything. That should make it pretty consistent, pretty deep.
And even today during qualifications, it was indoors. But generally, when you're in qualifications and you're shooting outdoors, and then you go into a closed finals hall, how different is that for you?
It makes it a little easier. You don't have to watch the wind as extremely. You don't even have the chance to do it. And you have to shoot your prone in 150 seconds. You're standing kneeling in 200.
Mm-hmm. 200. Yeah.
So you can just check with the wind, but you can't wait for it.
Mm-hmm.
You have to shoot.
Yeah.
You have
you
no
do.
Other opportunity. Just have to focus and.
All right, let's take a look again. Yeah, a little bit of a struggle there. We've got Arsovic, who is holding on to first place now by 1.7-tenths of a point over Zublasing, who's climbed up the scoreboard. Westerhelm is in third place, and Gray has now moved down into fourth place. I mean, she's only 2-tenths of a point behind Westerhelm, and Westerhelm's only 1-tenth of a point behind.
Yeah, that's nothing. But Arsovic is definitely getting up.
Yeah, she is. She's
getting her lead. New athlete in second position as well. Petra Zublasing increases her lead. Right up the scoreboard into and 52.5 is a very, very strong curve.
Exactly.
Especially for women. You must say women shoot a little less in prone usually than men do.
Mm-hmm. Yep.
So that's pretty impressive.
We're going to be moving on now to the second series. Once again, there's three series of five shots, 150 seconds to shoot at each series.
I'm actually impressed by Petra. She removed her cheek piece like a couple of months ago, and since that point she started shooting prone significantly better.
No kidding.
Yeah.
Nice. Starting off with a 10.6 for Zublasing. Sikorova, she has moved down the scoreboard. She's got a 10.8 to start off, though, so maybe this will move her back up. We'll see how the rest goes for her. Westerhelm with starting off with a 9.7.
Yeah, she starts struggling a little bit. She had a 9.7 in the last shot in the first string as well.
Got a 10.3.
It's not even that you need those really, really deep shots. You just have to be consistent to keep them within the 10 ring. And
good, 10.5.
I mean, usually you lose a lot more in standing. Mm-hmm. Most competitions get lost in standing, I would say.
Well, that's how everything just seems to turn around on a dime is once we get into standing. And you really think you know who's going to be going home with the gold, and it's the last shot, and all of a sudden you say, whoa, wait a minute here, things just changed around on a dime. Goswami coming off of a 9.0. The 9.9.
Yeah, we can see really nicely how she breathes.
Mm-hmm. We've got about 17 more seconds of this series. Yeah.
Stop.
We've got Arsovic is still holding on to first place. She's now up by 1 point over Zublasing, holding on to second place now. Gray has moved up the scoreboard. She's a half a point behind Zublasing, and Breeze is 1.1 tenths of a point behind. Now, still, you can't say that anything is for certain because we're going to be going into the standing position after this last series.
Yeah, I guess Adelan Goswami will have some trouble to get back into the game for the medals, but you never know.
Pretty much throughout the whole final until two excellent rounds in the prone position.
But yeah, 49.4 for Adela and 48.8 for Goswami. Those are pretty bad strings. It's tough to make that up.
For the next competition series.
Now, as you can see here, there's standing room only in the finals hall today, and I love that. And you see that oftentimes during the World Cup final, that everybody shows up. And, you know, even the fellow athletes that aren't even shooting on that day, they come in especially just to be on the grounds all day long.
Yeah. It would actually be nicer if you could combine it with the German championships at Munich, because there you have thousands of people being at the shooting range. Then it would be packed.
Right.
That would be something to think about for the future if it takes place in Munich anyway.
Mm-hmm. Exactly. That's a good idea, Henry. We'll have to look into that, definitely.
That has happened before, I think.
Yeah? Not in my 5 years. Okay, so this thing starting off with a 10.6. Nice, 10.4.
She shoots some salts prone.
Nice, it's 10.7 to start off for Breeze. Unfortunate 9.8 there. You can tell she's frustrated with that. Okay, coming right off that 9.8 with a 10.5. Let's see how it's going for Gray. She had a 10.9 right in the center there. And finishing off with a 9.9. We've got about 52 more seconds left of this series. And then we're going to be going over to standing. Now, tell us a little bit about what's going to happen between now and that 9 minute of changeover and preparation.
I mean, same like before, Pone. You have to set up quickly. And actually, standing is really tough to get in. Like Pone, you can just lie down,
right,
more or less. Standing, coming down and standing is a little trickier, I think.
Yeah, this is what we were talking about a little bit before, of which one do you think is the hardest. And it seems like it's a consensus that they say, everyone that I've talked to says, going from prone up into standing seems to be the hardest.
Yeah. 9 minutes. Actually, that's true. I didn't shoot a final for a very long time.
For a long time, exactly. All right, so things have changed around here. We've got Zublasing has now overtaken Arsovic by half a point. Gray is still in third place. She's 6 tenths of a point behind. Breeze is on her heels, 2 tenths of a point behind there. Lusami, actually, she's moved up the scoreboard. She is 1.6 tenths of a point behind Wu, and Sikorova now, who is in eighth place.
Goswami made a lot up with her last five shot string. She made up her 48.8 with a 52.8.
That's right. So let's just let these ladies go into this changeover and preparation time, and we will catch back up once they get in the standing position. And we're back here in the finals hall for the standing positions in three-position women event. I'm here once again with Henry Jungenell from Germany. Henry, it's really nice to have you here with me today. I really appreciate you being here. Let's talk a little bit about what's going to be going on right now. We've got two more series, right?
Right.
Five shots.
Right.
250 seconds.
I guess so.
Yes. After these two series, 7th and 8th place will be eliminated, and then we're going to be going into single shots. And after each shot, then the lowest person on the scoreboard will be eliminated up until I think it's about the 44th shot. We're going to find out our bronze medalists. And after the 45th, then we have our silver and gold medalists. Now, I'm not sure how familiar you are with the shooters here today. I think you are pretty familiar. But who would you say, or do you know, who's the strongest in the standing position?
That's a tough one.
That's a tough one, yeah, okay.
I mean, you could go after the Olympics last year. That was still after the old format. Adela did a good final. Jamie obviously did a good final. So they could pick up.
That's right.
But Petra is also a solid standing shooter.
Petra now is holding on to first place. She is up by half of a point. And we're going to have to see also, focus in a little bit on Byerly Gray, just to find out how she's going to cope with this. You know, how she's been having these back problems for a long time and finally has taken this year off to do a lot of physical training and also some work with a doctor who she said is finally she's found somebody who's getting to the root of the problem, which is really great. But I think that standing position for her is probably the most painful.
Most painful, definitely. Yeah. It's very tough on the back, that's for sure.
I don't know how you all do it, quite honest. I mean, I look at some of the way that you hold yourselves and how much your backs are arched, and I think day after day you guys train like this. And it just must put so much pressure on your back.
It does, but if you consider any other sport, I think if you do any sport on a professional level, it's not healthy.
That's true.
So why would shooting be different?
That's true. You've got a good point there. You know, it's a sport that you can do later on in your life. You can keep on doing it until you're old and gray, which is a great thing. But I think that it just wears on your body. So unless you can keep your body, you know, limber, or, you know, but just holding that position for such a long time, I don't know how many of you guys can make it to your old and gray, to be honest.
I think it's just really, really dangerous if you, while you're still young, when you're growing, still growing, that there you can get some dysfunctions and really big problems. Once you've grown up, I think, yes, it hurts, but doesn't get worse anymore, I would say.
Yeah. So during the developmental years of your physical body, then that's the time that you could probably see most of the damage. But if you were to pick up the sport after you completely developed, then you probably have a better chance.
You probably don't have any chance, I guess, to be on the top level.
But you have a chance of being able to walk straight for the rest of your life.
Yeah. But I think it's... quite a few shooters have problems, but none of the shooters disappear from the shooting world because of back problems.
Right.
Hardly any.
Yep.
So it's bad, but it's not destroying the shooters at all.
Okay, here's the birthday girl right now, Vesterhem. Only 20 years old, shoot down her birthday. And I wish I could remember who it was. There was another guy who it seemed like was always during the World Cup final, and it was always during his birthday, and he always seemed to make it into the final on his birthday. And I can't remember who that was. I've got to check into that.
But it'd be nice for Marlon to pick up a little bit.
Yeah.
I would really like to see her shooting for the medals.
Like you were saying, Zublasing has just spent, the last 3 weeks in China?
It's
3 weeks.
I think she and Nico came back 2 weeks ago.
Yeah. Like that.
But, they shouldn't have any problems with the time shift anymore.
No, I don't think so.
But it will be interesting if she can stay in the lead. If she does like she does so far, she has a very good chance.
We've got Breeze coming off of a 9.5. 40 more seconds to go in this series. And Bree's finishing off nice with a 10.8. Arsovic is holding on to first place now. She is holding on by 1/10 of a point over Zublasing, who's moved down into second place. Breeze is now in third. She's 6/10 of a point behind Zublasing. And Wu is right on our heels with 3/10 of a point. We've got Vesterhelm and Sikorova, who are on the hot seats right now. We've got one more series to go, and 7th and 8th place will then be eliminated. So they really have to shoot really, really strong to try to stay in the game. It is definitely, it could happen, without a doubt.
Very, very close at the top. We have a new athlete in first position. Andrei Arsovic goes back into first place. Petra Zublasing just 0.1 behind. We now have the second five-shot standing series.
Okay, so it's the last series here in the standing position.
And 7th place in this competition.
For the next competition series, load.
Okay, 5 more shots of this series. And it's Westerhelm, who at the moment is holding on to 7th place. And the thing is, they know now where they're standing.
Yeah,
you know, they've got Jack J down there on the floor, and he's giving off all the results. And so unless they're completely toned out of it, they know exactly how many tenths of a point they are also behind the next person or in front of the next person. So that adds a little bit of pressure as well, I believe.
Yeah, and they also have the screens in front of them saying or showing where they are. So even if you don't understand English like the Chinese, you still...
And I think that's important to have that, to have the screens in front of you. It might be distracting to you all, but you've got a point there with the Chinese that maybe don't understand.
Yeah.
You have to make it a fair play for everybody.
Definitely.
Yeah, of course, you can choose not to look down at the board if you want to, but I don't know how easy that would be. I'd be very curious, so I'm sure that I wouldn't be able to not look at it.
Actually, they are wide next to your screen, so if somebody shoots an 8, or if it's just 2 shooters left... or 3 shooters, there's no way you don't see something flashing up when you're aiming or something.
Okay, Gosami, she's done a really good job of moving up the scoreboard. She was holding on to 8th place for a while now, and now she's up into 6th place. And we'll just have to see how this last series goes for her.
Yeah, she just had a bad pawn string of 5, and she got back in the game.
All right, Jamie's starting off with a 10.4. She's now coming off of a 9.8. Got about 110 seconds. Oh, 8.9, and she can. I have a feeling she knew that was going to be the result, not what she was looking for. Nice. This is a really great string for Zublasing right now.
Yeah, she doesn't want to give away her first.
Not at
first
all.
Position.
Also, Wu experienced a shot in the 8 ring. Nice, finishing off with a 10.5. And Bree's coming off a 9.2 with a 9.1.
She's struggling with standing. Why now? But but it looks like Adela and Marlin.
Yeah, I'm afraid that's right. So Westerheim and Sikorova are going to be, unfortunately, having to go today. You know, they've made it here all the way to the World Cup final, which is a huge feat in itself. And so you definitely have to take your hats off to them. Eighth place, Adela Sikorova.
It's a bummer going into the finals first and dropping out last.
Exactly. Exactly. And that's where the qualification conversation comes up often, you know? And we've got Westerheim, also Marlon Westerheim from Norway, finishing up in seventh place. We're going to be going into our single shots in just a couple of minutes. We've got Zublasing holding on to first place by a half a point over Arsovic. Wu is now in third place. Gray has moved down the scoreboard, and she's tied up, actually, with Breeze in fifth place. And they're 9/10 of a point behind. Now, with the scores the way that they are right now, the difference, what do you think? Is it just a fight between Zublasing and Arsovic?
For the first place, I would assume Wu had some problems with her last five shots. So as long as she doesn't get back into the game right now, there will be hardly any chance to get back into the game.
Arsovic starting off with a 10.1. Wow, so we're seeing a 10.7. Very nice. 9.4 for Gray. You can tell that she is not happy with this result. And unfortunately, we're going to have to say goodbye to Jamie Byerly Gray from the United States of America. You know, she made it in here. She was the Olympic gold medalist, and she's taken this time off to take care of herself, which is really the most important thing. I'm sure we're going to be seeing a lot of her in the, you know, next year. She'll probably get right back into the game.
At latest, when they are quarter places again.
Exactly. That's when everything gets really heated up here. All right, so we've got Breeze who's in the hot seat right now. She's 9/10 of a point behind. Zublasing, you know, with that 10.7, she's put in a little bit of a difference between herself and Arsovic. She's 1.1/10 of a point ahead.
Yeah, I think if nobody shoots eights, the scoreboard should be set right now, but you never know.
That's right, you don't even know, but a nice 10.3 there by Zublasing, and that's it for Breeze, unfortunately. Even with that 10.3, she's missing out on fourth place by 4/10 of a point, and there she is, Laurence Breeze from France. Now, this is a tough one. I mean, we've got Gosami, who is almost 2 points behind Wu. That's going to be really hard to make up. And this is the toughest shot, I think, so far, because somebody's going to be going on the podium and someone's going home in fourth place. And unless something really drastic here happens, I have a feeling it's going to be Gosami.
Yeah, exactly. But at least she can shoot without any tension or anything. She knows she's got nothing to lose right now.
That's right. Nice, a 10.6.
Oh.
Wow, 9.0 for Wu. That keeps her in the standings. Gosami was almost 2 points behind, is only 3/10 of a point behind now. But we are going to have to say goodbye to Gosami from India. And Zublasing is really putting the pressure on right now. She's 2.8/10 of a point ahead of Arsovic, and Wu is almost 3 points behind her. But this is when things get crazy, you know, in my memory of this this event, that I just have a feeling I know exactly what's going on. Oh, of course, you know, there's almost 3 points separating each one of them, and then something really crazy happens.
Actually, the main thing is just to shoot some focus shots. You don't need a 10.7 at that point anymore. You have to make sure that you don't push it or anything. It just has to be a clean shot.
Okay.
And then usually, worst case, it's a solid 9. Mm-hmm. That's enough at that point.
Okay, we've got Zublasing. She's coming off of a 10.4 in her last shot. Nice, with a 10.6. Fantastic shooting. And that is going to give us our bronze medalists today. We have Wu Liuxi from the People's Republic of China. She will be going home with the bronze. Fantastic work from Wu Liuxi from the People's Republic of China. We're going to be moving it on over to find out who's going home with the gold, and I've got to give it to Petra. 4 points ahead almost. I mean, really.
Ben, are you surprised that it wasn't a Chinese winning?
I'm absolutely shocked, as a matter of fact, that there's going to be a different anthem I'm playing today. It's not that I don't like the Chinese anthem. I certainly do. But it's nice to have a little mix-up every so often, too, Henry.
Yeah, but it looks like the Italian.
Yeah, yeah.
And you're living in Italy.
I've been living in Italy for almost 14 years now. Okay, Arsovic finishing off with a 9.7. Definitely going to have to keep our eye on her in the next upcoming years. Jeez, Zublasing finishing off with a 10.6. Excellent job. Almost by a 5-point lead. Petra Zublasing has grabbed the gold. She is the World Cup final gold medalist in the free position event. Excellent work. She's going to be commentating with me for the men's event, so we're going to have to find out how she's feeling about this gold. And there she is, our silver medalist today, Andrea Arsovic from Serbia. Wonderful, wonderful job there. Henry, I want to thank you so much for joining me today. It's nice to have you right by my side, and I wish you the best of luck tomorrow.
Yeah,
the prone in the prone event. Go get them, okay? Let's do the gold medal interview tomorrow, okay?
I'll try my best.
Okay, thanks a lot.
Thank you. Thank you.
The medals will be presented by Mr. Gary Anderson, Vice President of the ISSF. He is accompanied by Mr. Volker Kaschle, member of the competition jury. Your bronze medalist, representing the People's Republic of China, Wu Liuxi. Your silver medalist, representing Serbia, Andrea Arsovic. And your gold medalist, representing Italy, Petra Zublasing. Ladies and gentlemen, please rise for the national anthem of Italy.